In this video, I'm going to show you how to use your Mac and the FSU's VLAB to do the SimNet-based assignments if that's the way you want to go. That's the way I recommend that Mac users do it, especially on the assignments that you have to use a Windows version of Excel. So here we go. All right, so normally we would just be working on our computer and Excel would be on their computer. But the Macintosh doesn't have all the bells and whistles that the Windows version does. The good news is that FSU has created a VLAB platform that has all of the Excel 2019 functionality built into it. So up here in the upper right, we have FSU's VLAB with Excel 2019 running. Down here, we have our Mac. And up here on the left, we have SimNet. So when we start our assignment, the file is up in SimNet. And what we have to do is we go down and download it from SimNet into our Mac. And it downloads into our downloads directory of our Mac. Now, this is where we would normally just take off and start working on in the Mac. But a lot of the homework assignments are more complicated than the Mac version can handle. So what we have to do is we have to open up FSU's VLAB. And then we upload the file to the cloud. And then open it up in Excel, and we work on it. And here we have a young lady working feverishly on it, and she's smiling. She is really enjoying working on Excel. You can just see it in her eyes. So now she's worked on it, and she's generated a bigger, better final file. And she then has to get that file from the cloud over to SimNet. But to do that, she has to go back through the Mac. So the first thing she has to do is to download it from the cloud to the Mac. So she downloads it, and now both files are sitting on the Mac in the downloads directory. Usually when you download it with the exact same name, it'll put a parentheses 1 and parentheses after the original file name. Or if you do it 2 times, it'll put a parentheses 2 parentheses. Or God forbid you do it 3 times, it'll put a 3 there. But at any rate, then once it's on your Mac in your downloads directory, don't open it on your Mac because that might strip out some of the functionality that you put into it from the 2019 cloud-based version. So once it's on your Mac, just upload it up to SimNet and let it grade it, and hopefully you get the 100. Now let me actually demonstrate me doing that on the Mac, doing this entire process. So I've borrowed a Macintosh from the College of Business, and I've opened up Canvas, and I'll go to McGraw-Hill SimNet. You could also access certain things from the modules directory, but I have to do it to show here from a student's perspective, so I have to do it here. Go to Module 0, here's my Quiz 0, and here's where you download the file, you upload it, and then you submit it for grading later. But first I have to get the file, download it from SimNet to my Mac. And I'm going to hit Save File as opposed to Open File. And I want this to automatically do this from here on out. I don't ever want Excel to actually open the file automatically on my Mac. So if I look at my downloads, there's the file. And I can open it in my Finder. And yay, there it is. Notice the time. There we go. So now the file is on my Mac. And I want to work on it on FSU's VLAB. So I just Google FSU and VLAB. And there it is. It's always the top hit. And sign in. So I've already logged in and I made it a favorite. But you can go to the apps and then put the little star next to it and make it a favorite. I'm just going to open it from here. So now I have Excel open. Normally it would come up with a blank Excel file, but I've already got one open. So it's going to ask you some weird things about resolution. Don't accept it. Go over here to Display Resolution, and you should always say just Auto Fit. If you use one of those other choices, tabs are going to disappear and all kinds of funky stuff. So we want to upload it from your Mac to the cloud. So I have to go to my Mac and say, hey, it's in my downloads directory, and open it, and I want to upload it to the cloud, and I always tell students, you can put it a variety of places, but I tell students to put it on the desktop up in the cloud. So that's where it is now at. So now I will go over to File and say Open it. And then I surf to the desktop. So go to Browse and find the file. And if you sort by the date modified, the last one you put up there is there. So now the file is there, and I can go back to the SimNet page and say, okay, what do you want me to do here? So here's step one, open the file. Hey, did it. I enabled editing. Woo, we're flying now. Apply the slice theme to the workshop. So how do I apply themes? That's under here, under page layout. There's themes. There's the slice. Oh, boy, that looks so good. I am so proud of myself. Now, edit the title in cell A2 to monthly sales by department. So type in monthly sales by department. And it has to be case sensitive. So if it says capital letters, small letters, whatever, you have to do that. Don't put a space at the end or anything weird like that. Edit cell D6 to 1950. 1950, hit enter, and I could go on and on and on, but I'll do that in a different video. That's the purpose of this video, is to show you how to get the file to and from the cloud. So upload the project, upload and save it. So I'm going to save it, which saves it on my desktop up in the cloud. Now what I have to do is I have to take that file from the cloud and download it back to my Mac. So if I hit here and then go to this PC and desktop, there's that file that I just edited. So I can either double click on it and see it bounced into my downloads folder. And now I have two files there, the original one and then the one with the parentheses one after it that is 4 minutes later than the previous one. So that's the file that I want to submit into SimNet. And you can change the file names like that. It won't slap you around or accuse you of cheating or anything. So go to Downloads. And there's the most recent one with the one at the end. Upload it. And yes, submit the file for grading. And it's going to give me the result. And it's going to give me a pretty cruddy score because I didn't do it all. But you get the idea. I got 20% or 4 out of the 20 points. So by default, it shows you everything that you got wrong. If you want to see what you got right, you can click on the little icons and turn different pieces on. So I got those two right. And those four are completely incorrect. And then the other one is a partially incorrect one. So what I would do, I would go back and explode these out and do what it told me to do. Up in the cloud, up in the VLAB site, and then I would download it again, and it would be giving me a -2 or (2) at the end, and then I would submit that and hopefully get a perfect score. Quizzes, I let you resubmit up to 10 times, God forbid, and assignments, you get 3 tries at it. So make every try count on those assignments. So here I demonstrate. If I make some changes and then re-download it back to my Mac, see here, the latest version has a 2 in it. So if I wanted to submit that, I could. So again, what we did, we started with the file up in SimNet and we downloaded it to our Mac and it went into the downloads directory. And then from there, I opened up the VLAB and launched Excel up there and then used the little orb, the little black half circle thing, to upload the file from the Mac up to the cloud. And I put it on my desktop up there. And then I worked on it. And she's still excited about working on it, man. And then I took that file and downloaded it back to the Mac. And so now both files, the original file and the downloaded file, are both sitting in the downloads directory. The more recent one has the (1) at the end. And then I'm ready to upload it to SimNet. So I upload it up there, and There we go. Yay, 100% on Excel. Zeus would be so proud. She is ecstatic over a perfect score on Excel. I tell you, you can be that person too. So that's how the Mac users use it, and I hope this video helps. Thanks a lot, and have a great day.